the demand and supply. We went through this very simple example. But apart from this concept, we need a lot more things to become successful trader in India. For that, we need to get into detail why the demand and supply timing system is what he has proposed. So, as I told you, we have three modules in the course. First one is trading, which will get you deep into the system what we have. It will give you the trading skill. Basically, how to identify levels. Good level to enter, good level to come out. Is there a third level? Anybody? Third level is very important.
Sustaining.
No. Entering maybe at 100, target 140. Fantastic. Do you need to know one more level? Okay, so this is top loss.
Let's see what is that.
Why it is important? Now, we know there are two groups. One group of novices 90%, other one is 2%. Of the people who have the this 2% of the people who have the skills of the education required. Education is not a problem at all. They will get educated anyway. But they have the skill of becoming successful traders and investors. Now, along with the skill or with the skill, okay, we call this four pillars of successful trader and investors. These are very, very important. Okay, this requires discipline, commitment. Without this, any institution or any profession will not be successful in the market. Okay. I have heard of any institution who deal in trading and stocks failing. Have you heard of any institution who are dealing in trading and investment failing? Yes. Actually, no. Why? Because they are taking from these donors. Very simple. But banks fail. Okay, financial institutions fail. Because if they don't have discipline, they will fail. But an institution or a profession is trading and investment. I have not seen anybody fail. If they are disciplined. Now, market timing strategy is the one which will go into. This is what I said, what he developed. Very simply, it is a concept. Buy in the demand zone, sell zone, or in the common terminology, buy at wholesale rate and sell at retail. So we get into that. Second thing, risk management. I will just tell you market timing strategy. Technically, market timing strategy, okay, is strategy which will give you buy and sell. Tomorrow you decide to become an investor or trader. How will you identify the scripts and how will you identify the levels at which you have to enter and which you have to come out? Okay. Basically, your system, this market timing system, will indicate you the scripts, entry time, entry level, and exit. Okay. There's one more level that we will tell you later. Risk management. Okay. Risk management is a strategy which will allow a professional or institute to be there in the business. Very important. Very, very important. The 98% of the group fails because we don't follow these four pillars. The risk management is a strategy which will allow an investor to be there in the business, to run the business, to be there in the business, in spite of incurring losses. Okay. How many of you expect 100% success in all the trades? Fantastic. I think you know, not fantastic. Normally, at least, some 5-6 people raise their hand. But if you're expecting lesser than 100% of the success ratio, you are at it. Nobody can have, even the best of the institutions cannot have more than 80% success ratio in the stock. In fact, in India, the normal success ratio which we experience is about 60-60. Okay. Even professionals, I'm sure a lot of institutions, they will not have more than 60-65% success ratio. That is how the market is. Okay. Raji, but with 60% success ratio, can you make money?
Yes, definitely.
Anybody feel that with 60% success ratio, you cannot earn well? With 50%, if you have success ratio of 50%, can you earn well? No.
Yes.
In the next two slides, you will know why, whether it's possible or not. Coming to this, risk management, as I told you, that's a strategy which will ensure that an investor's business is not hampered when he incurs loss. That means in your risk management, you should expect some losses in your business because your success ratio normally on a long term cannot be more than 60. That means what is important that 30-35% of the loss, losing trades, what you experience, how you manage it, that is important for you. And that is a key thing which differentiates between the 2% group and 98% group. Anybody agree? Or disagree? The key thing is how you manage that 30-35% of the loss making trades differentiate between that 98% and 2%. Generally, what happens when the price starts coming down, you are invested in it. The 98% of the group, they become more optimistic. They think it will rebound. If it starts still start going down, then what they will do? They start praying more. Still it doesn't come up. Then the fear factor comes up and they sell. select a huge box. Whereas this group has a strategy for it. In the next slide, we discuss permanent psychology of trading. We said, you know, if you invest based on the sentiment model. Similarly, psychology of trading can help you in handling your mental state and emotions. Emotions like, for example, you expect, you invest 1 lakh rupees, suddenly you make 5 lakh rupees profit. What happens? What happens to your emotions?
Happy.
Exactly. Then what happens? Then what happens? That is very natural.
More chances to lose.
How?
We start buying.
Exactly. Okay. So you may have goals in your trading psychology. If you experience successively 5 or 6 losing trades, take a break for a year. Vice versa. If you experience 5 or 6 successful trades, take a break. Or you expect 5 times return of success, suddenly you get multiple more returns. You take a break. I'm giving examples.
That means you have to withdraw it or you have to
just
stay away from trading.
Enjoy your profit for a day, come back later. Otherwise, what happens, like Prakash said, normally human beings tend to splurge, take more risk and lose or whatever you mean. Okay, I'll just give an example. In the psychology part, our students are taught how to manage your emotions and mental state. It can be, you know, when you sustain huge loss, when you sustain huge profit, successful losses, how to manage your trade. Unless you know that, you tend to, you know, splurge your water profit. Or you tend to come out of the business. Okay, managing your emotions and mental state is very, very important. Trading plan. Okay, you won't have a trading plan. Trading plan is like, I can give you a common example. Constitution for a country. What is a constitution for a country? It tells you what to do, what not to do. Right? Similarly, the trading plan, which you are going to decide, will have all the aspects like, you know, what is going to be a capital, where are you going to invest, which scripts you are going to invest, which scripts you are not going to invest. Okay? What is your duration? Like, you know, are you a hourly trader, daily trader, weekly trader, monthly trader? Or are you only investor, stock investor, you don't trade at all? You are going to define everything in writing in the trading plan. Right? What is the advantage of a trading plan? What is it? If you put all the things in a trading plan, what is the advantage? See, generally, common investor will not have anything of this. He will not have what is the capital is going to put, where is going to invest.
You know the last.
So basically, you are documenting the way you are going to do business. So once you are in this 2% group, you are not amateur, this is a serious business for you. Whether it's a part time or full time, doesn't matter. It's a serious business for you. Okay. Once it's a serious business, you have to document your business. How you are going to? When you are documenting, do you think it's easy? For example, what capital you have to define? Normally, common investor will not even think of. Okay. But in your business, you are going to define. My initial capital is going to be 1 lakh, 10 lakh, 1 crore, whatever. But you are going to, when you define, you are going to think 100 times and two. Why 1 lakh? Why not 2 lakh? Why not 1 lakh? And when you define, you are not going to cross it. That's the advantage. I just give you one example. Like that, a lot of aspects are there which you are going to write down in your trading.
It's more like a business plan.
Exactly. So you have to have discipline following so that you don't cross it. You can change it every day, not a problem. It's your trading plan. It's not rigid. You can change every minute or so, not a problem. But you need to change it with all thinking and writing. For example, initially you said 10 lakh capital. Now you want to change it to 20 lakhs. Okay. Now, if you want to change the word 10 to 20, how many times you need to think? It's not easy. So, when you have to write what you are going to do, it's not easy. Okay. So, basically, these are the 4 pillars which differentiates 2% group and 98%. No rocket science. It's just discipline which is. Okay. Do you think these 4 things will ensure a business is successful? Okay. No, no. We'll get into some critical aspects. I'll just show you the what you got tip of the iceberg. Okay. Critical aspects or salient features of the course which will differentiate 90% group and 2% group. Any investment can have 5 repercussions, 5 outcomes. Large loss, small loss, break even, small profit. Right? Now, which one is critical for your business? All of your professional business plan, you are into trading and investment. Now, out of these 5, which one is most critical for your business?
Break even. Large loss. Loss is the critical.
Hear me? Break even. Okay. Why does generally a business wind up? Why does generally a business wind up?
Close
loss.
Loss.
Because
of loss.
Why does business
close?
Basically, investment is no more confident that it can succeed.
Okay.
Or it can bounce back.
Entire capital erosion.
Capital erosion. Why does generally
business plan? Because of no business.
Most of the cases, business winds up because they suffer
large loss.
This definitely, you know, maybe, but definitely most of the moment they experience large loss, has increased. So the critical aspect to ensure the sustainability of a business is to ensure that you are not incurring. Now, see from the other angle. Now, the 2% of the institute, they have the skill to avoid harm. Stop loss. I'll tell you what is stop loss. Now, the moment you have a skill of avoiding blind loss, see the
small loss.
And the small loss, I told you, you are going to incur small loss. Or I told you are going to incur loss. Okay. But the moment you have the skill of avoiding blind loss, you will either incur small loss, you have to incur break even, not a problem, small profit. If you toss a coin, what the probability of winning or losing?
50%.
Even without much of education skill, if you get into stock market, either you will have a small profit or small profit. Okay. Now, with the skill and education, you should be able to convert either break even or small profit. The 2% group, institutions and the professionals, okay, they just follow this simple risk management. This is a risk management technique. One of the risk management. First one, I'll tell you what is stop loss. Okay, Kumarji ne bataya, stop loss is important. The moment you have a discipline of defining stop loss, the large loss is taken away. Okay. Now, next outcome is only 4. These two can keep coming. Okay. But with your skill and luck, you should be able to convert break even or small profit. But this is what the institutions. This is one of the major factors, major aspect, major discipline, which institutions follow, which a common investor will not follow. The 98% group will not follow. Right? So, the large loss is the one which you have to. Now, what is stop loss? What many of you don't know what is stop loss. Now, if you are not sure, the price is stopped at 20. The price may come down below 20 hours. For example, okay. Now, what will you do? Madam, how about the cattle? Now, you don't know. For example, price started coming down. It is at 18 now. Okay. It can go down also. It can go to 10 rupees. So, what will you do? Now, the 2% professionals in these days, when they enter into it, they have 3 aspects in mind. Without 3 aspects, they don't enter. They have entry level, entry range, exit, profit taking, and one more is called margin of the stop loss. They define a stop loss here. Okay. They say if the price comes below 18, they don't think twice. They just sell it off and incur 2 rupees. No emotion. For 40 rupees profit, they are ready to incur 2 rupees loss. No emotion, nothing. The moment price touches 18, the loss. Very simple. But 98% of the people fail to follow.
They buy.
They try to average. A lot of things are price. They are happy their price is going down. They average. They buy more. It goes down. A lot of things. But the 2,000 people, they don't think. No emotions. They just sell when the price comes to 18. Now, before they get into the trade, they have the range to come in, getting the range to come out, and the range to book profit. All the 3 is there in their trade plan. Are they risk management? So when you get into a trade tomorrow, okay, you should expect 5 outcomes. Any trade, every single trade you get into from now onwards, you should expect 5 outcomes. Large loss you have to avoid by defining stop loss. For example, Reliance, you buy at 1,330. Now you say 1,250. The moment it comes to 1,250, you come out. If the 80 rupees loss, come out. The target may be 1,450. You should expect 30-35%, 50% of loss losing, and you should have. Many of you are not aware of one more terminal for reward to risk ratio. Prakash, you have to know even 50% success ratio, the business cannot be profitable, right? It's carefully go to this. Reward to risk ratio is nothing but in a trade, what is the reward you are expecting against what risk? So, in this trade, for example, the reward you are expecting is 40 rupees and the risk is 2 rupees. Okay, so this is 20:1. Here, you are here. In this trade, for a profit extra 40 rupees, that's a reward. We are ready to risk 2 rupees. So, reward to risk ratio is 20:1. Okay, now, actually, in the stock market, the reward to risk ratio is depending on time horizon. If you keep the stock for months together, years together, your reward to risk can be quite high. 10:1 or 12:1, 15:1. For example, in the case of MRF, you bought MRF at 2,250 in 10 years back, and now it is maybe 50,000. Okay, many times, maybe 2:1 or something. Right? It depends on the time horizon. But for our students, for hourly trading, we suggest a risk to reward or reward to risk of 2:1. Means you can put, when you are investing, for example, 1,000 rupees is your entry level. If you are risking 50 rupees, you should have a reward of at least 100 rupees. Means in this trade, your target will be 1100 and your stop loss will be
900.
Generally, how are we trade within a day? People trade, we suggest 2:1. In the case of daily trading and other things, that can go up to 3:1, 4:1, 5:1. Okay, now we take, let's take two examples. In the case of 2:1, we want to risk ratio. If you don't understand, ask me, very important. Okay. I'm just telling you two aspects of risk management, other things. There are many more which will be told in the course. Now, even if you have 2:1, you got to risk. Even if you only 34% success ratio, I'm not even saying 50 or 60, even with 34% success ratio, your business will be still making work. Okay. Same way, if you target a reward to risk ratio of 3:1, even with 25% of success ratio, not 60 or 50, 25% success ratio, you are not incurring loss, you are making. Okay, these are the smaller techniques. Why the 2% institutions and professionals on a longer horizon never fail? Cutthroat. Okay, the moment they fix the stop loss, they put it in the system. No emotions, no second thinking. The moment it comes to the price, they sell. They are ready for it. That is their risk management defines.
The stop loss, you have to define every day.
It depends on the portal. Uh-huh. In some portals, you can define it for the
immediate.
I mean, the one which I use for till the next quarter end, uh-huh. If you till the next expiry end, it depends on the code. Like, you know, that's another report. You can put it. Okay. These are the just two, you know, aspects which will make, which will differentiate the 2% professionals and 98%. Like, there are many techniques, simple techniques, no rocket science. Any rocket science into this? Better tell me. This is just a question of defining your trade plan. For example, you can define a trade plan saying that, Prakash, so you can define a trade plan. I will not get into any trade below 3:1 reward to risk. So what happens if you don't get into any trade below 3:1 reward ratio? If you are having 50% success ratio, you are minting money. Even with 40% or 35% success ratio, you are minting money. Okay. Maybe some few people say, you know, I want to be a long term investor, weekly or monthly. In the case of weekly or monthly, minimum you can expect is 4:1 reward to risk. In that case, even with 20% of success ratio, you can be profitable. So only difference is, the moment your reward to risk ratio is higher, number of trades available will be, but we are tell our students, not a number of trades, not a quantity of trades what you take, it's a quality of trades. For example, 5:1 trades, 5:1 trades are equal to 1:5:1. Got it? So these are the simple techniques. You have to have some formal education, skill, you follow the four pillars, discipline, which will make you a professional investor. No rocket. Any doubt on this? Yes, it is. Clear? Got it? So, once you attain a good skill, more than 50% success ratio will come automatically. Just I again repeating, you wouldn't have seen any investor, you know, the professionals or institutions failing in the leadership. In fact, you know, earlier we said, you know, the 98% group is a dollar. Okay. You should have a goal of, you know, being in this 2% group and becoming a dollar to the society after people. Right? Many people are doing it. For example, Rakesh Vindhya, you would have heard, he's adopted a lot of schools and villages. Maybe, you know, he's not publicized that. Okay. You should have the goal of, you know, being in this 2%, and then you donate to the society at your vision. Don't be in, you know, the 98% group and forcibly donate to this. Here you are forcibly donating and you are hard at the money. Don't do that. So if you want to be a trader or short investor, make sure you are in this 2% group and willfully you donate to the society. That should be your goal. Okay. Now, I told you we have three modules in the workshop, in the course. The first one is called Ignite. In the Ignite program, okay, you will be taught all the technicalities of the system. I'll show you the system and how the system works. Basically, take again. Okay, how to use the system, what are the features of the system. From there, how to mark your entry level, exit level, and the third one is stop.
Yes.
Very, very important. So, this is a 1 year overall program, Ignite, 1 year overall program, wherein you have a trader mentor. See, in OTA, one of the features is, you know, we don't have any normal teaching. All our teaching staff are acting traders. So that we will have a trader who will be mentors for you. Supporting tool, I will show you after this slide. And you will have online trading platform, personal trading plan. The mentors will help you to design your own personal trading plan. You will have a trading community of people who will be there in the course. So maybe tens of hundreds of people will be there. You will communicate with them. And the education which you are imparting is actually the same education being imparted all over. And since 1997, more than 2 decades, we have been, you know, teaching this market timing strategy, and lakhs of students are successful and trading and investing successful in the market all over the world in all classes of business. This is not only for stocks. Stocks, option, futures, bullion, forex, commodities, anywhere in the world you can take.
Theory comes back.
What?
Theory in fact.
What? Decline is a 12-month course. 20 months in the first month. First month is an educational month. Basically theory. In the first month, we'll have 20 sessions. Wherein the theory will be taught in. As I told you, you may not know what is long, what is short, what is stop loss. All these concepts will be taught. I mean, in repeating, 13-year-old students, 77 to 77-year-old homemakers have gone through the courses and they will. So, we start from the step. Anybody can even learn. The only thing is the effort required. Maybe if you are already in acquainted with this market, the effort required in the beginning will be less. The effort required by a people person who doesn't know anything, maybe even slightly more in the beginning. But once you come to a level, then it's a
20 full-day session.
No, it's a whole session. Our education council, they will tell you exactly. So, now let's see what is this OTA patented demanded supply, market timing, strategy. Now, how many of you are acquainted with the charts? Not many, right? Now, this is called candlestick chart. In detail, you will know. This is called candlestick chart. Basically, here, as I told you, once you analyze a chart, you can define, you will have the skill to define supply zone and demand zone. Back to this example, in the case of onion, it's very easy to define a zone. But in the case of script, the zones can change, okay, very frequently. In the case of day trading, every hour it can change. In the case of weekly trading, every day it can change. So, in this chart, you will be able to define the supply zones and demand zones. Now, how the zones get created is a skill you need to develop. Okay? I'll show you the charts of other companies. Maybe, you know, in the beginning it may look quite haphazard. You may not be able to read it. It's like, you know, before you know, learning driving, you would have thought, you know, driving is very difficult. But once you understand it and you know, develop the skill, it's very easy. So, in this chart, you will know, you will have the skill to identify supply zones and demand zones and define the levels, entry level, stop loss level, target level, and get it. Any similarity between this and this?
Yes.
Now, as you already know, place an order to buy when the price comes to the demand zone. Like onion, invariably most of the scripts, they keep going up and coming down. Isn't it?
Yes.
Right. So when the price comes to demand zone, you will buy. If the order is filled and the price reaches the target, then sell it. When it comes to the supply zone, if the order file drops below the demand zone and hits the stop loss, what will you do? No emotion to the, it should become mechanical. Before getting into the trade, decide three price levels, entry, target, stop loss. Okay. When you get into the trade, the entry is done, then you have only two levels, stop loss and target. Whichever is first, okay, you are ready. If it hits the stop loss, you know what loss you are going to incur. You are ready, you are happy if it hits the target. The only difference, the only input which is required is, are you going to touch the stop loss? No. Stop loss is a tool where you will minimize losses. Are you going to touch the target? Yes, sir. Stop loss, I am again repeating, you are not going to touch it. No emotions, nothing, no rethinking. Before getting in the trade, you defend the stop loss. It comes to stop loss, no thinking, you come out. But I said, let's go. Are you going to touch the target?
Sometimes.
Center, yes sir? Shoot? Yes sir? No, you are. How about this? Are you going to tackle with the target? Actually, we touch the topic. So, focus. Wait a second. Are you going to tackle with the target? What he told you, out of the five outcomes, large loss, you will avoid through stop loss, right? And small profit with your skill,
you will make it larger.
Yes,
with your skill, you should try to convert small profit into. Okay. So, when the price comes here, based on your feel, if you think that it can still go up, okay, you up your target and wait for it. And to get a safer sign, we call it trailing stop loss, which I can explain to you. What you do, the stop loss what you have, for example, I will give you an example here. How to increase your profits, how to convert small profit to large. Okay. In this example, for example, price came to 70. Now for some reason, all of you feel that your price can touch 100. So will you select 70? Now earlier your target was 70. Now when increase your target, you will up your target price to 80. Now when the price comes to 75, still you feel very strongly price can touch 100. Then what do you do? Increase your target to
90.
Is that enough?
Safer side is enough.
Now you have gained so much, right? From 30 to 70 prices gone. Do you want to lose it? Suppose if it doesn't go up, it comes down. No. So the technique is stop loss earlier was 18 rupees, bring it to maybe 65 or 70. So if the price comes down, at least you will get this much of profit. Price touches maybe 100. Bring up the stop loss to 90, target to 100. This is possible if you're lucky, it's possible. So you are ensuring that, you know, the profit which you have made already is, this is how you have to convert small profit into large. These are the simple techniques, no rocket science, simple techniques, which the 2% group knows and then make money. So in the second month, the first month is education month, in the second month, 40 control trades will be traded by the students. 40 control trades. What is meant by control trades? You will have your mentor with you. Okay. You can decide the trades, the levels, entry, exit, top loss. Get into the trades. Okay. At least you have to do 40 control trades live. Now, many of you are experiencing trades for the first time. What if you experience loss? I am repeating, our OTA, our objective is not only education. We want to develop students, you know, right, enough skill before the course. So if any loss is incurred here, OTA and Sharekhan, we will pay if you incur any loss. Okay, that's the confidence we have in our education. Okay, within 1 month, at least you have enough education skill. Okay, to see that, you know, you don't incur loss. But since we want you to develop skill, we want you to get into trade without any hesitation. Okay. So we want you to get into these 40 trades freely. So that's why we say if you experience any loss, the loss will be borne by OTA and Sharekhan. And the profit is. So mentors will guide you to take 40 control trades. Capital, small capital will be required from your side. There will be rules how to get into the trades. Okay, as I told you, if you are disciplined enough, you can definitely avoid large loss. Purpose of this is to practice before taking risk with your own capital independently. Okay, and we feel if you get into 40 trades on your own, you will at least develop basic fundamental skills, which is, you know, which is required to get into. Personal trading plan we discussed. Okay, so the mentor will help you to define your own personal trading plan. Now the mentor will not make trading plan for you. Why? Now 25 of us are here. 25 of us can have 25 different types of trading. 25 types of capital, 25 types of, you know, the basic trade, the time frame. That's why the mentor will help you to define your own. After that, 10 months of mentoring with you. As I told you, it's a 12 months overall course. First month is theory. Then you will take control trades. The next 10 months, every day, we will take 2-2 sessions every day with the mentors. Okay. Whatever you want to discuss with the mentors, you can discuss with them. And whatever trades, all our mentors are active traders. Whatever trades mentors are taking, they will share it with you. Got it? You can question them. Why did, how did you come to, you know, this entry level? Is this entry level good enough? You can discuss. So what happens at the end of 1 month? 1 month you spent on education, 1 month you spent on trial trades without any risk. And after that, for 10 months, are available for you to develop skill. There's a mentor available with you, okay, every day, every trading day, with whom you discuss.
Every day is the wrong way.
There will be 2-2 sessions. Our counseling is exactly the same. 2-2 sessions every day, morning and evening. Okay. They will discuss their trades with you. They are active traders. Every day they will be taking trades. If you are confident, you can follow those trades. Lefty.
Can you spend in person also, here in person also, on your own?
Online. And if you have made your trade, you can discuss with your mentor. Is my trade okay? The levels are from various. Basically, we will develop skill into you in these 10 months so that, you know, after that, independently you can trade. You know.